creating a video for your assessment too. Find the video that you would like to have as your first video. Right-click on the video, then choose Open With and choose Movie Maker. If Movie Maker doesn't appear in the shortlist, then choose another app. Click on Movie Maker. And wait for your video to load. Once loaded, you can insert before or after. I'm going to insert a photograph. So earlier I prepared a document and had listed the 8 technologies from assessment 1. And then took a snippet, which became a graphic. You can move your photograph to the beginning of your video, and then I'm going to insert another graphic, which is the 3 technologies that will be applied to the scenario. At the beginning of the video, I'm going to insert a title. And remember to put your name as the author of this video. The title can be animated, it's simply choosing which one you prefer. There's more in the drop-down. Each time you hover over one, it shows you a preview of what the animation would look like. Once you've made your choice, simply click and it'll be applied to your title page. Then playing the video, you can see how the animation will appear. Then it goes into your 2 photographs. Of course, you would list your technologies, not just technology 1, but you'd actually list what technologies you were looking at. And then we enter into your first demo of applying your first technology. At the end of your first demo, you can click and then add another video. This would be a demonstration of the second technology you applied. Then once your video loads, you can add your third technology that you applied. Then at the end of your combined videos, you can do some credits. For the sake of this assessment, we're going to change this to your reference list, and you would copy paste your APA list to the end here so you can attribute where you got your information from. Now we've got 3 videos and there's a join between the 2 videos. Normally when you play, there's kind of like a speed bump between the 2 videos and it doesn't transition very well. So the idea is to apply a smoother transition between the first and the second video. So it's actually up on Video Tools, Edit on your ribbon, and then you'll see fade in, fade out. And you'll make it each one medium. Then you click on your second video and apply the same. You'll see that fade in, fade out has been applied, and then the third video, fade in, fade out, medium. So when we play the video through, the transition from your first video will be much smoother into your second video. Now, if you want, instead of that quick transition, what you could do is create a document that would be kind of like an introduction into your second video, and you can make it like your first graphic. You'd do a snippet and then insert the graphic in between the first and the second video. It'll act as an introduction into your second video. Now, if your entire video does not have narration, you can add captions at strategic points. So this first video is a demonstration on applying Excel, which was the technology that I chose. Then when you play your video through, the caption will be applied to the first part of your first video. So as you can see, playing through the video, we haven't actually got to the table slices yet. So what would be a good idea is to have a caption introducing the video, which is the demonstration of using Excel. And then later in when the video comes to actually applying the table slices, that's where you would add the caption. So we need to find that on the video. So just clicking through until we find where table slices is being inserted. Then we do caption, and then we say it's the table slices. At the moment, it's a white font on a white background, so we need to highlight and change the font color. And this caption introduces the table slices quite nicely. So you can go through your video and add captions at strategic points, introducing the different technologies and what you're wanting to show the viewer. So second video, I'm introducing Xero as my second technology. We've got white font on white background, so we need to change the font color. And you would continue introducing your third video. Now, if there was a part in your video where you actually want to edit it out, you actually want to remove it, you can do what's called a splice. In my video demonstration of Xero, there was a part where I clicked on part of the ribbon and it actually just loaded an empty page. So this page is just empty and not worthwhile keeping in the video. So what I'm going to do is find the part where it actually changes from the drop-down list of selections, and I actually want to apply a slice there. So I find the point on my video and then right click and then split, and then I run through and find the point where it would be good to add another split, so I can remove the entire empty page that's on the video. So I'm just finding the right place to apply the split. Then I right click, split, and then the segment that's now in the middle we can remove entirely. Then when you play the video, it just looks like you did a demonstration of options that are available, and then quickly go to your next tab on your ribbon for your demonstration in the video. So that's how you can edit pieces out of your video that you're creating. And if at any stage you would like to add narration to your video, simply click on the home ribbon, choose a point in your video where you would like to add the narration, click on record narration. You would obviously need a headset that has a microphone, and the narration will be added underneath that point where you're speaking about the segment of that video. Last part I want to demonstrate is if you actually want to end part of your video at an earlier point. So you would find a point on your video, then you would right click, set end point, and your video would be ended a lot sooner than when you first created the video. Saving, please click on Save Movie and use the recommended for your project. This one, I believe, by default is an MP4, but highly recommend that you click on Save Movie, recommended for this project, and you'll always have it saved in the correct format. Thank you for watching.